are lucky. We have two countries presenting today. So Kristine Melby from Copenhagen, Denmark, will be doing her presentation about Denmark and showing all the other kids how to do it. And we have a lot of volunteers for the rest of the year. I'm not sure. I think we're probably going to have either Russia or Brazil next time. So that will be October 4th. Oh, yeah, Lauren told me where to stand, and I just completely ignored her. So I think I know everybody. I'm Maureen. I'm the Director of International Programs here. For those of you who are joining us electronically, eventually, I'm Maureen. And Otero is delighted because we bring the world to Otero each year. This year we have over 75 students from 35 countries, which is kind of amazing here in the Arkansas Valley that we bring the world to Otero in such a significant way. And okay, so we have students trickling in. I know we had a couple students that had classes right up till 12:15. So I'm gonna hand it over to Kristine, because I know she has a lot of awesome things to say. And then, Kristine, do you mind introducing your teammates when you're done and kicking it over to Germany? Is that appropriate? Okay, well, come on up here, and here's Kristine.
As Maureen said, I'm from Copenhagen, Denmark. I'm a sophomore here at Otero. I play soccer, and I'm 20 years old. So Denmark, it's a very small country in Europe. Can some of you guys see it up here already? No? No idea? It's right here by the arrow. Can you see it? No? Not really? Can you see it now? It's right on top of Germany. It consists of like 208 islands and like a half island that's connected to Germany. So, yeah. As I mentioned, it's a small country. It's half the size of Indiana. We have 5.8 million people living in Denmark. In Colorado, there's 5.6 and a half, so almost the same as Colorado. And at a point in time, we had Sweden, Norway, England, and Germany under, or a part of Germany under like our ruling. So we were way bigger, and then we made some stupid mistakes, and we lost Sweden, we lost Norway, we lost Germany. Or some of it. And then it takes 5 hours to drive from the top of Denmark all the way over to to the top up here. So it's a small country. Some fun facts is that we have the oldest flag in the world, or the oldest documented flag. The legend says that it fell down from the sky during a crusade in Estonia in 1216, I think. And as you can see, it's on the picture, it's falling down, and then we were losing the battle, and then they prayed to God, and then he gave us the flag, and then we won the battle. Another thing is there's no mountains in Denmark at all. Our highest stop is, or our highest spot is 560 feet. Right now we're at like 4,800 feet or something right now. I'm not completely sure, but in Colorado, the typical height, or like the average height, is about like 6,000 something, 6,700. So Denmark is very flat. And then another fun fact is that more than 50% of Copenhagers recycle or bike every day. And there's like a little video, so you can see how many people actually bike. And that's the normal, just every day. And people, they don't really have cars. It's normal to have a car per family, and some families share a car with their neighbors. So it's, yeah, it's not usual to have more than one car per family. But we bike. So in Denmark, you don't have to be afraid of the cars. Be afraid of the bikes. And if you don't know the biking rules in Denmark, you're really screwed. Yeah, you shouldn't be biking. It's frightening. But we bike in every kind of weather. Like even in the winter time, like when there's snow, as you can see right here, people, they still bike. Okay, so we have some weird traditions. We have Fastelavn, which is this thing. Like in Denmark, we hate witches. We've always hated witches, and we still kind of do. So back in the days, they would take the witch's black cat, put it in a barrel, and then they would hit the barrel until the cat died. But right now, we just put candy in the barrel, and then the children, they dress up, and they hit the barrel, and then the candy fall out, and they eat the candy. Another thing is that on Midsummer's Eve, we celebrate Midsummer's Eve, and in Sweden, they have this really beautiful flower fixture, and everyone, they dress up in white dresses with flowers around their heads, and they dance around in circles, and then we burn witches. So we have this fake person that we put on the big fire, and then we burn them, and then we sing songs. When I came here last year, and we went to the fair in Rocky Ford, and then some of the people were like, "Have you ever been to an amusement park?" And I was like, "Yes, because in Denmark we have the two oldest amusement parks in the world." And that's a fact that no one really knows. And then we also have extra letters in the alphabet. We have the E, and the U, and the O. So, E, U, O. Yes. And then, as you see this hat, that's the Vikings. They didn't have horns in their hats, so that's like a fake myth that everyone thinks, and is in every movie, but they don't have horns. Another fun fact is Lego is Danish. It stands for play well. So every time you're playing with your Lego, you better play well. We're also the second happiest country in the world. We got, or Finland, they took our place in 2019, and they're still up there. So I don't like Finnish people. We also have a crime rate of 0.001%, and yeah, that's a very little. That's 1 in 100. No, 1 in 1,000. Yeah, sorry. And then we're the least corrupt country in the world. I found all these facts online, so I hope they're real. But it just tells something about how safe Denmark actually is. For example, we have, like, let's say we're going to a cafe, we're bringing our baby in our stroller, we just leave it outside on the street, and we go in and eat. So the baby gets air, and no one can stop the baby because it's a safe country. Yeah. Then we have very clean drinking water. I don't know what to say more about that. And we speak Danish and English. A lot of people think I only speak English. But we learn English in school, we learn German too, and we learn French in school too. So we speak a lot of countries. No. We speak a lot of languages. Yeah, and then some of the food we eat a lot is potatoes and pork. We're actually known for our pork industry, and we supply Germany with 70% of their pork. So that's a lot of pork. And then we eat a lot of rye bread, which is this brown bread you see up in the corner. And I love that bread. I brought it here. I have it in my freezer, so I can eat it, because you can't buy it over here. And then if you put a lot of fancy stuff on it down there, we call it like open-faced sandwiches. They're good too. And then we have the Danish pastries, as you guys know them. We call them Vienna bread, because we got them from Vienna. So they aren't even Danish. So the stuff you know as Danishes aren't Danish. But yeah. And then we eat a lot of fish, because we're close to the sea. Some famous Danish people, we have Hans Christian Andersen, made The Little Mermaid, The Ugly Duckling. Then we have Niels Bohr, he's a physicist, he won a Nobel Prize for his atom model. Like, he found out that the electrons, they like move in a shell around the atom, and then that gave birth to a lot of stuff. So he won a Nobel Prize. And then we have an author, she was very famous for her tales about Africa and her time living there, and she wrote under the pseudonym, or like the fake name, of Isaac Dinesen, because no female writers were really allowed to publish. And then we have a philosopher, I'm not really sure what his philosophies were, but he's famous. And then we have our queen right now. So Denmark is built by a monarchy, but it's a passive monarchy, because we are actually ruled by a democracy. But we still have our monarchy. So that's our queen. And then we have our prime minister. And I like that they're both female. Yes. some famous Danish actors. We have Viggo Mortensen from Lord of the Rings. Some of you guys might know him. We have Mads Mikkelsen. He's been in a lot of movies, like Fantastical beasts and where they live, and Star Wars, Doctor Strange, Indiana Jones. What's 007?
James Bond.
James Bond. Yeah. And then we have Nikolai Coster-Waldau from Game of Thrones, Pilo Aspect from Game of Thrones, and then this one I kind of cheated because she's half Danish. But Scarlett Johansson. Yeah, and then Alex Anderson from the Vikings. And then we have a lot of Danish athletes, a lot of soccer players over here on the right. You might know the second name, Kristine Eriksen, very famous. He also had a heart attack on the field and got resurrected, and that's a lot of people that know him for that too. Then we have Pernille Harder, which is the lady down at the bottom. She won Europe's best player in 2018 and 2020. We have some other players that aren't soccer players. For example, Nick Johnson, he's a handball player. He has won the world best handball player in 2011, 2012, 2015, 2018, 2019, I'm pretty sure. And then we have Jonas Vingegaard, he just won the Tour de France, and he won last year too. We have a race driver, Kevin Magnussen, Formula One, if any of you guys pay attention to that. And then we have Victor Axelsen, yeah. He plays badminton. He have won the Europe Championship in 2017, the World Cup in 2018, the Olympics in 2020, yeah. So he's a good player too. And then we have Caroline Wozniacki. She plays tennis, or she did. In 2012, she had the most like winning streak of 71 weeks. So she didn't lose one game in 71 weeks, which is a lot of time. But yeah. Then we have some famous musicians. So some of you might know Mir, like this song. I think a lot of you guys know him.
Once I was 7 years old, Mama told me, go make yourself some friends or you'll be lonely. Once I was 7 years old.
And then we have this one, which a lot of you might know because of the movie that came out not too long ago. They're Danish. And then last year I presented this, and Dean Addington, he was like, why aren't my favorite rock band up there? And I didn't really think they were like that important, but he really thought they were important. So this one was for him. It's Volbeat, and they have this song that's very famous in Denmark, at least, because they sing in English and in Danish. And right now it won't start. But yeah, this one was for Dean Addington. But so the verses are in English and the chorus is in English in this song particularly. About Denmark is that healthcare, dentists, and schools are all free. Our taxes are a little high, though, but it's all worth it, I would say. And then we get paid to go to school by the state if you're over 18. If you live at home, you get $200 a month. If you don't live at home, you get $800 a month. So that's so you don't have to work while you're studying, which I really like. So I moved out when I was 16. I moved out when I was 18, and I could do that because of this. Yeah, but we pay 35 to 52% of taxes, but the average salary in Denmark before tax is
are 44,000 a year, and in Colorado it's 55,000 a year. But we get a lot out from it. Like, we aren't scared to go to the doctor, and I don't know what to say. School is free too. Like, there's a lot of good stuff, even though our taxes are high. And this photo is from my graduation. As you can see, all of us kids are sitting at my school, and we're wearing these like Fisher hats. We all get them on when we graduate. Like, you have the square hat and you move the tassel. We get this hat on and we wear it for like 3 weeks. And then we're walking around and everyone sees it and everyone congratulates us. So it's very fun. Our currency looks like this. It doesn't say specimen on our notes, but it says so here because it's copyrighted. But our coins have holes, or some of them do. I'm not really sure why, but there's 3 crowns on them, and we call them crowns. But the 3 crowns are from Norway, Sweden, and Denmark. And then our money has colors. Yeah. Oh, and one USD is 7.5 Danish crowns. Some attractions. Nyhavn, which is all these colorful houses. And we have the Round Tower, which was built in the 1600s. And it's known for, like, it's just a spiral. There's no stairs, so you just walk up the spiral all the way up to the top, and then you can see over all of Copenhagen. And then we have the Little Mermaid over here, and it's Kristine Anderson. She's very small. So when we say little, we mean, like, from the table this tall. So she is little. So if you go to Denmark, and you're gonna see the Little Mermaid, she's gonna be very little. A lot of people get disappointed by that, though. These are just some of the houses. This is the castle that the kings and queens, or not the king, the queen and her family lives at. And that's the house that, it's called the king's house because it's by the king's garden. But yeah, just some houses. And some streets. And these are just some pictures from Denmark. That's the prime minister of Denmark. And she was just walking at the beach by where I live. And then we were walking there as my school class because we wanted to go swimming in the ocean. It's a thing that we have to do with the hat on, so we went to do it. And then she was there. We said hi. And then there's some other just pictures of me and my family in Denmark. Yeah, I might go even quick, but it's because Germany is like next. But yeah, this is by my summer house. And that's my summer house. It's like a vacation home we have. And that's us in a sports event. And that's me buying street food. And that's me and my brother on the bikes. And that's inside like a big windmill, because we're also known for like our windmills in Denmark. And that's just by the lakes. Yeah. I don't really have more. That's Nyhavn again, but all the colorful houses. And this is inside of one of the amusement parks. So you can see there's a roller coaster over the side. Woohoo! That was it.
We have one question for Kristine. One? Nobody?
Yeah, I got a question.
Okay, I knew
so
you would.
How come the currency isn't the euro?
Well, I'm not sure about that, but I think it's because, like, in Scandinavia, Norway, Sweden, and Denmark, we're kind of our own little thing. Like, we're a part of Europe, but
just Scandinavia.
Yeah, it's just, like, in Norway they have Norwegian crowns, in Sweden they have Swedish crowns, in Denmark we have Danish crowns. And then all of them have 3 crowns on them for the 3 countries, yeah. But there was a debate, I think in 2014 or something, around there, about if we should change to the euro, and everyone said no, or not everyone, but it was like highly voted no. So we kept our currency.
Any other questions? Can you explain the concept of hygge?
Oh, that's kind of hard. So we have this word in Denmark called hygge, which is like this feeling of togetherness and coziness, and it's like, let's say you're sitting in your couch with your family and you have your blankets wrapped around you and you're drinking hot cocoa, that's hygge. But it's like a concept that we have and a word that can't really be translated. But yeah.
But I usually translate it to like cozy or nice, but it doesn't really get the full meaning of it. Any other questions?
Okay. Go ahead and introduce your teammates.
Okay, so the next people up, it's Emma and Juliana from Germany. Okay. They're both freshmen, it's their first year here. We're very glad to have them. Yeah. And they're gonna talk about Germany, the country they're from. So I'll give it over to them. Here you go. Hello, so we're from Germany and we're a bit nervous because Kristine is amazing. That's Emma and I'm Juliana. And we're from different parts of Germany, so we're going to talk about that too. Because Germany is really different. Okay, so let's start.
Yeah, so we're going to talk about some general facts and we will talk about some traditions and traditional food we eat in Germany, and then we will present some major differences that we noticed since being here, and then we will show you some German celebrities and places of interest. So let me start with the general facts. We are 83 million inhabitants in Germany, and Germany is also in Europe, and our capital is Berlin. We talk in German, and we pay with the euro, and the time difference is plus 8 hours from here, so right now it's like 8-something p.m. And Germany is divided into 16 parts. I'm from Saxony, and Juli is from Bavaria. In the north we have the sea, two different seas, the Baltic Sea and the North Sea. And in the south we have mountains, the Alps. Yeah, here you can see the Baltic Sea and the Alps. Yeah.
Okay. So I'm going to talk about the food. So we are famous for potatoes. Everyone call us potatoes, like German potatoes. And then we have sausage, which is called Bratwurst in German, and sauerkraut. That's like, here you can see it, like potatoes, sauerkraut, and sausage. That's like pretty common to eat in Germany. And then we have bread, which we really miss in the U.S., really. we eat pretzels too. We eat pretzels too. I don't know, like maybe you've heard about pretzels, but they're really good. We eat pretzel. That's like a dish, I don't know, like it's cheesy and not noodles, but I don't know how to explain it. It's really good. So if you're ever in Germany or Austria, try pretzel. And that's another, like, it's from Bavaria, especially, but we eat it in Germany. It's Schweinebraten, like, it's pig. It's pork. And then, there's no translation for it. Yeah, it's really good too. Okay, and we're famous for our beer. Yeah, I think that's the most famous thing. Okay, so another fact is really realized in the US there's a lot of fast food, and in Germany we rarely eat fast food. We like, every time we ask our parents to go to McDonald's, they told us no, we have bread at home.
Yeah.
So that's that's the answer we get most of the time. Okay, then let's talk about the traditions. First I start with the Oktoberfest because it's in Munich where I'm from. And I don't know if you ever heard about the Oktoberfest, but basically it's like not a festival, but like it's a traditional fest where you drink a lot of beer and dress in strange clothes, as we call it. Tracht, that's like, okay, you can see here. Okay, so you can see the whale. thing we wear. It's like a lederhosen.
And here's the view of it.
You can see it better in the next picture. And at the first day of Oktoberfest, they go like to Munich and play music. Actually, I've never watched it, but it's pretty famous. And yes, we're all dressed like this. So basically, you can imagine us the whole October, September, we're dressed in these kind of clothes. Even to school, it's like pretty common to do that, but only in Bavaria.
So another tradition that we have in Germany is that the children get cones, like colorful cones, when they enter school after kindergarten, and they are filled with like candy, school equipment, toys, and stuff like that. So yeah, we call it Zuckertüte, and it's very common in Germany. Like everyone gets a cone when they start school. Yeah.
Then we have Carnival,
which is in Cologne. It's also like a festival which is about drinking. And everyone dresses in a strange way, how they want to. And then you go to the streets and party there. And we do that like in the kindergarten too, of course, without drinking. But like we dress up and I don't know, it's like pretty common to do it in Germany too. Celebrate Carnival.
Yeah, then Christmas is very like traditional in Germany, not only the Christmas Eve, but the whole Christmas time, like the whole December. We go on Christmas markets, as you can see, that's a Christmas market. And yeah, we bake a lot and just enjoy that the family comes together.
And then we have the Maibaum, which is in the May. And it's like a tree we, I don't know how to explain it, but like we have a tree in our cities, and then there is like the other city tries to steal our tree, and it's like a, I don't know, like basically every time the tree gets stolen, and it's also like, I don't know, it's just a traditional fest. I don't even really know what it is about, but it's really common. I don't know, it's like a pretty cool time because the other cities try to steal our bow and buck tree, and we try to save our tree, and it's pretty funny.
And in this time of the year, we also burn witches, Kristine said.
That depends very from, for example.
We don't, like in Bavaria, we don't burn witches, but we do the Maibaum thing, and then
we burn witches. We have the Maibaum and burn witches. So the differences that we noticed are, of course, like the driving and drinking situation. Like in Germany, we are allowed to drive when we turn 18, and also getting your driver's license is more difficult, and it's so much more expensive than here. Like we pay around 2 to 3 thousand euro to like get our driver's license, and we are allowed to drink when we turn 16. Beer and wine, and like the powder alcohol we can drink when we turn 18. And then it's like kind of similar to Denmark. We have a lot of public transportation and go by our bike or walk, so we don't use our cars that much, and I like that because we don't have to rely on people who have a car. Then the food is very different, as we already said. Here the people eat so much like fast food, and in the cafe there's so much fast food, and we really miss our German food and bread and German breakfast especially. And then the health insurance system is different, like in Germany. Our insurance covers every medical treatment or doctor's appointment. And in Germany we aren't allowed to have guns. So that's a difference. And just the size of the country is
I don't know, when we are driving here, sometimes you can see nothing in the distance. And in Germany, you can always see something. And yeah, we could drive from north to south or east to west, like in half a day or something.
In a day.
But yeah. And yeah, in Germany, the stores are closed on Sundays always, so it's, yeah. Yes.
And the stores close at 8 or 7, sometimes at 6, so we cannot go shopping in the night. I don't know if you ever heard about our actors, but we have Til Schweiger, and he's famous in Germany. Then we have Heidi Klum. I don't know if you ever heard about Germany's Next Top Model. Yeah, that's the woman who runs it. Then we have Elias Zavari. Like, that is basically, from every German girl, the childhood crush. Yeah. Okay, then we have some places of interest. We have the Fernsehturm, that is in Berlin. Then we have the Kölner Dom, that's in Cologne. Oh, we have the Brandenburger Tor, that's also in Berlin. Schloss Neuschwanstein, that's, I don't know if you maybe have seen it in Disney once. That's in Bavaria. And then we have the Zugspitze, like that's the highest point in Germany and the Alps. Yeah. Okay, do you have any questions for us?
Joel?
Yes, okay. you didn't mention the Autobahn. Have you driven the Autobahn?
Yes.
Okay. Did you drive it really fast?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, so in our tribal lessons, we go on the Autobahn, and like I think for me it was the third tribal lessons I ever took, like the third time I was ever in the car, and he took me to the Autobahn, and I had to drive 140 km/h. So yeah, we learned to drive really fast.
All right, any other questions?
So what are you studying here?
I'm studying science, biology right now, but I haven't decided what I want to do.
I'm doing an Associate of Arts in Psychology.
Any other questions? Kristine, what are you, do you still want to do education? Are you? Okay, you used to want to be a teacher. I don't know if you...
I'm not sure.
You're not sure. Okay. All right. Well, thank you. You all three did amazing.